This is your video orientation to LJS 300 from the Schoenberg Collection in the Kislak Center, University of Pennsylvania Libraries. This is a manuscript copy of the Calendarium and Ephemerides. It was published in 1474, but this manuscript copy was made in around 1500, so it was actually written after the book was published. It's quite nice. It's big. You can see it's quite thick. It has these tabs, so it's easier for you to find your place in the book. The binding is original. It's leather over boards, and it has one of the remaining original clasps and the bosses. It's quite nice. The whole manuscript is quite nice, actually. So it starts out with a calendar, the calendarium of the title, and then it moves on to the ephemerides. And what the ephemerides are a series of tables that for every year give the position of the sun and the moon and the planets for every day of the year. And it can help you do things like calculate when there are going to be eclipses. And so here at the front of the book, the start of the book, and then at other places throughout, there are these diagrams of various eclipses, and then here as well at the start of each of ephemerides, there is a diagram of an eclipse. This book might be the most famous because it was used by not this exact copy of the book, but the Calendarium and Ephemerides was used by Christopher Columbus to predict a lunar eclipse on the 29th of February, 1504, when he was in Jamaica. And so he told the people in Jamaica that there was going to be this eclipse and they'd better do. Well, he didn't say there was going to be an eclipse, right? He said, the sun is going to be eaten up unless you do what I tell you to do. It's sort of an awful story, but it's an interesting tie-in with this book in our collection. The unfortunately, you can't use this book anymore because it was only it only had the dates for, I think in this one, between 1480 and 1506. So it's no longer of use, but it's still an interesting example. If you'd like to find out more about this manuscript, you can visit Penn in Hand. There are high-resolution digital images of every page, along with a complete description of your manuscript. This is your video orientation to LJS 300.